I'm Mark from MyHGT, and today I'll walk through the sensor and exciter selection methods migrated from VirtualLab and that are now available in Simcenter 3D finite element model correlation. Pre-test simulation supports efficient product validation by improving the placement of sensors and exciters to achieve better modal test results. We will start by determining the sensor locations and directions for the frame of an electric off-road vehicle. This means creating a spatially distributed set of candidates, which will automatically be selected to reduce the off-diagonal components of an initial MODMAC matrix. From there, we can define the exciters. Exciter locations and directions will be determined that best excite the target modes at the central locations using drive point residues. Finally, we will create a pre-test model and share it with the test engineer. This is done by selecting the solve, sensor, and exciter configurations, as well as manually or automatically defining the wireframe. Okay, let's go through that in greater detail. To begin, adjust the customer defaults to set matrix plot origin to bottom left. In order for this change to take effect, you must restart Simcenter 3D. We have already set it properly here, so we'll skip the restart. Next, open the simulation file from the start directory. Once that is loaded, we will adjust a few preferences. First, toggle File, Preferences, User Interface to reset the dialog memory. Then, File, Preferences, Function Plot to set the maximum displayable row and column count to 150. Now we're ready to get started. Enable the correlation tab of the ribbon if it is not already visible and create a new pretest solution. Accept the default parameters by clicking OK. The pretest solution will point to the only existing normal mode solution inside the sim file. In this case, a Simcenter NASH Trend solution 103. Let's define a group of nodes that will be used to define candidate sensors. It is important to sufficiently space these nodes in order to avoid clustering of sensors by the MODMAC algorithm. In the pretest planning group of the correlation tab, select maximum spread node group. With the type filter set to node, select all nodes using Control A. Set the maximum number of nodes to 200 with a minimum distance of 100 millimeters, then apply to create group 50. We've already reviewed the mode shapes of the frame and know that there are many modes of the taillight brackets, so we need to include more of their nodes in the candidate node groups. Therefore, we will repeat the previous operation for each of the two brackets. In the border bar, set the method to related nodes and use a sim navigator to select the mesh under the taillight right collector. Set the maximum number of nodes to 10, the minimum distance between nodes to 10 millimeters, and apply. Repeat this step for taillight left and click OK. To combine these groups, shift select 50 through 52 in the sim navigator, right click and hit union. Next, we will use the combined node group to create the candidate degrees of freedom. Under the sensor selection node, right click and edit candidate degrees of freedom. Set the method to nodes by group and select union group 1. Now, we need to define initial sensors where the mode shapes have large displacements. In this example, there are candidate sensors all over the frame, so we'll concentrate on the taillights, which have several modes and a frequency range of importance. To make things simpler, turn off the display of all meshes and make the node display independent from other SimCenter objects by clicking Show and Hide Nodes Independently. Show only groups 51 and 52 to isolate the nodes on the taillights. Edit the required initial degrees of freedom under sensor selection and set the method to no method. Change the view to trimetric and select the two nodes as shown. To capture nodes in the rest of the structure, change the method to nodes by group and select the group initial. This gives us 12 initial sensors or 36 initial degrees of freedom. Create a new sensor configuration by right-clicking the configuration nodes in the Sim Navigator. Set the algorithm to MODMAC, enter 180 as the number of degrees of freedom, and set the type to triaxial. This means we're targeting a maximum of 60 triaxial sensors. Leave the MAC value limit to 0.2. Hit OK, then right-click to solve the configuration. Right-click and view the information of the solved configuration. The MODMAC algorithm takes the initial sensors, computes the max off-diagonal MAC, and then reduces it by sequentially adding degrees of freedom from the candidate sensors. As seen in the table, it took 26 nodes or 78 degrees of freedom to reach a MAC value of 0.196. plot the ModMac evolution chart by right-clicking the ModMac 1 configuration and selecting Correlate. Modify the output to ModMac evolution and click Show ModMac evolution bar chart plot. Here you can see the maximum off-diagonal MAC term of the AutoMac matrix as a function of the selected degree of freedom, with the leftmost column representing the value of the initial degrees of freedom. Node 13882 brought us to 78 degrees of freedom and maximum off-diagonal MAC of 0.196, as reflected in the right-hand column. To validate the result graphically, we can plot the AutoMac matrix. In the pretest planning group of the correlation toolbar, click Plot AutoMac. It's hard to determine the exact value in each box, so we will adjust the lower limit of our color axes. Now we can see that all off-diagonal terms fall into underflow and must therefore be below 0.2. Let's turn our attention to the exciters next. Under Exciter Selection, select the Sensor Degree of Freedom node and right-click to initialize from ModMac 1, our sensor configuration. Note that 78 degrees of freedom appear beside Sensor Degree of Freedom. We will leave Candidate Degrees of Freedom undefined, allowing the DPR configuration to use the Sensor Degrees of Freedom as exciter candidates. Right-click and select New to create a configuration. Modify the method to DPR and select OK. Right-click to solve DPR 1, then again to select exciters. Set the number of driving points to 5 and plot. This matrix plot shows the 5 best candidates sorted by decreasing DPR weighted average. The best exciters excite all modes, which is reflected by a high weighted average. To get a better understanding of the plot, we'll adjust the upper limit to 0.04. From here, we can see that the first two nodes, 23158 direction Z and 11201 direction Z, are much better than the rest. So, we will set the number of driving points to 2 and click OK. Now we will create a test analysis reference solution from the correlation tab of the toolbar ribbon. The automatic wireframe method should be selected, as well as ModMac 1 and DPR 1. Preview the wireframe and press OK. Click No on the pop-up dialog box. A test analysis reference solution model is created with the sensors given by the ModMac 1 configuration, the exciters taken from the DPR 1 configuration, and an automatically defined wireframe. We can visualize the analysis modes as displacements applied to the automatically generated wireframe. An AutoMac wireframe is an ideal tool for novice users as it does not require switching to the FEM nor understanding of manual element creation tools, but it is also possible to manually create a more detailed representative wireframe. Select ModMac 1 and right-click to generate matching degrees of freedom set. Create degree of freedom set only. Expand the new solve set and create wireframe elements for ModMac 1. Click Yes to allow the work part to be switched to the FEM and back for plotl elements to be automatically created. We will use the default wireframe element settings. Make the FEM the work part and navigate to the Nodes and Elements tab for the Element Create tool. We will now modify the wireframe we just created. In the Element Create dialog box, select 1D plotl type elements. Turn off automatic collector creation and assign the destination mesh to the existing ModMac 1 wireframe mesh. Now we select nodes to create plotl elements. The objective is to improve the wireframe visually, so there's more than one right way to do so. To select this manually improved wireframe later, we'll create a group. Set the selection filter to element and then box the entire model. Now make the sim the work part again. Create a new test analysis reference solution, but modify the wireframe method to manual. Hit the group reference button, then locate and select the manual wireframe group we just created. Press OK and click No to override sensor information. We can now compare the solution results for each of the wireframes. Notice how the manually created wireframe on the right makes it much easier to visualize the model. Finally, we need to export the pretest model to Simcenter Test Lab for use by the test engineer. Right-click one of the test analysis reference solutions in the Sim Navigator and select Export. Set the format to SC2TL. and set a path for the file. Then assign a component name if you'd like and press OK. In summary, we used a MODMAC algorithm to create a sensor configuration containing viable sensor locations and directions. We then created an exciter configuration using the drive points residue algorithm. To finish, we exported a test analysis reference solution for the test engineer. Once the test results are validated, the next step is to use the correlation tools to compare test and simulation mode shapes and frequency response functions. The final step is to update the simulation model to better match the test data and create a validated finite element model of the frame which can be used for other simulations. And now you're ready to perform your own pretest simulations using SimCenter 3D Finite Element Model Correlation. Thank you for watching.